Hi my friends, hope you are doing good. And this video I am going to share my way of presentation in the direct tax and indirect tax papers. People, you may ask me that why are you telling only for ISCA, DD, AM and IDT? The thing is that it's the most recent group which I have cleared and I remember it, the contents well. Okay, coming to the paper direct tax and indirect tax, we all know that it is the lengthiest. Like, of course AMA is lengthiest, but at least it has some facility. Like, say it's not that theory covered there, we can manage it. But coming to DT and IDT, it has a lot of theoretical combined with application. That is the main crux. And coming with the less 15 days of time at max, what we need to do. Listen, we all know that DT and IDT paper, that any paper of CA final is fast track. You need to, once you keep the pen, you must be keep on writing. You can't stop. That is the basic criteria. Not stopping is a criteria. So coming to this paper, if you have seen my ISCA video, I have told you what are the basic requirements to maintain a paper. Similarly, here you must get, once you receive the answer sheet, bubble it off. And then write the first, like any answer which you pick up, answer to so and so question is center of the heading. Complete all parts of the question at one place. And each part of the question, 3A, totally completed, 3B should be the new paper. So total 3A, 3B, 3C must be in one place. And first question is mandatory, but it's not compulsory to start first. Okay. But coming to when you receive the question paper and you have time to read it, don't jump into analyzing if you know or don't know. Just go through all these things first thing, any question of this paper, just go back and see what is the required part. So once you need to read the required part, then you'll understand what to do. Suppose if you're reading all the content of adjustments or the plus and minus which you need to do, and then see the question what you need to do, it will give you tiresome experience in 15 minutes. So once you get the question paper, any question, see what is asked to do. Did they ask you to do MAT calculation? Did they ask you to do total income or computation of the trust, or what is that they're asking? So once you see that question what to do, you'll recall the chapter automatically, then see the questions above the lines, you'll recollect the adjustments. That's the first criteria which you need to do. And don't write anything on the paper. And when you get the MCQs, don't rush to it because MCQs in direct tax and indirect tax papers will be application based. So you will not find anything within the para. You need to remember it, and every option looks very similar. And once you take the MCQs first, your mind will be thinking on those MCQs again and again, and you will not focus on 70 marks. At least in 70 marks, you have step-by-step marking where you can score well, but in MCQs, if you put a wrong answer, it is wrong. Right? So just go through the question to recall the topics, because some topics may be related in the question paper also, and come back to question paper. Fill up the answer sheet, then now comes how to prepare. How will you present? As usual, draw the right margin. Then, every question in the direct tax, maybe some here and there in the transfer pricing part, has a paragraph writing purpose. But apart from that, everyone has numbers and adjustments. So what you will do, you will draw the column. You will keep inner column ABCD for the points. And then, suppose example, total income computation. Total income computation of Mr. A or Mr. B for the assessment year, so and so. That should be the heading, okay, of the table. Then the number, then the particulars, amount. Then comes the first adjustment or the first line, like it may be the net profit of the person, or maybe some starting point of the income. Write that, keep it in the outer column. Two columns must be there for the amount. One is for inner working, one is for the outer one, okay. And then when you start, you go to the first adjustment. You write A in the inner bracket. You start writing, for example, HRA computation. Generally, in our CA intermediate or IPCC at my point of time, I used to write note 1, then complete all blanks, keep amount empty, turn the page, write working notes, and then keep note 1 and write. So just imagine the burden now in final, just turning front and back. You can't do that. Time is your time equal to marks. In general, time is money for business, but here time equal to marks. So keep A point. Write that, suppose computation of HRA, suppose you have that point there, then down, write all the section number of so-and-so of HRA, the 3 points of calculation, lower of the 3, take that amount to the outer column, and then the remaining amount to the balance, the next outer column. So that will help you in two ways. first thing, your explanation will be done there and there. You need not remember and see what is note 1, what is note 2. And when you turn back, suppose if you want to write notes at the end, and this HR became third point in your note, and in your answer it is second point, just remember the confusion creates to you to see what you're doing. And then it also gives bad impression to the examiner that you didn't present well. He should also turn left and back. That's not possible. Then if what is second benefit? Second benefit is that you have completed there the point itself explanation. Your examiner will be relieved that you know something. He goes step by step marking. The first question may take 4 papers also. It's okay. Write every adjustment below it explanation, which section, which subsection. Try to recollect till the subsection part because you are in CF final. If you are intermediate student also, it's better to remember it. Then explain the provision, plausible in technical language or in your own. And then do the calculation. Keep the amount in the second column and then to the external column. The resultant amount. Total will be computed. Like that, if you do one question whole thing, you can be relieved. Come on, you have done 20 marks question or 8 marks question. Like you can guarantee say I'll get 5 to 6 out of that, or sometimes 7 also. So that is the way of writing any question in the DT. Similarly in IDT, suppose you got reverse charge or you got GTA. Explain there and there what is GTA, what are the benefits, why you are not taking it. Suppose example, blocked grid, section 17. Which subsection you are using, is it 3 or 5, why you are not getting the credit, what is the provision, that there and there. So the entire question, suppose there are 6 points in GTA thing, including reverse charge, every point, write that given text of that in the question paper, then explain it in the saying the note for that, write the amount, compute it off. That will give you, save your time, show the knowledge, and also you will be in a flow. But suppose for example in the GTA question or in the blocked credit, you have suppose example 17, 3, 4 and 5. And you wrote everything, then turn your page, write note 1 for 17, 3, 17, 4, you recollect what is it again. You need to again revise that statement in the question paper. So why all this trouble? Right. So write there, the explanation then and there, complete the question, you are done. I got a 58 in DT, 2 marks less of exemption. I believe that's because I might have not written subsection somewhere. This is the way you need to complete your DT and IDT. That will give you a flow. It will represent that you have knowledge and you have written what you know. And when you're writing a point, your brain will recollect some matter out of it. Just write it down. And in exam, always first in, first out. Okay. So what you remember first must be written first. First in, first out. That is the best way. If you take a second chance, you get confused and take something wrong. Then after coming out, if you should not check your answers after you come out in your book, but if you do certain kind of checking and you will feel, yeah, I first remembered that one, why did I took this one? So first in, first out of experience, I'm saying first in, first out, and write in this manner. As I've said to you, it will be, your paper will be very full-fledged. Your time will be saved and whatever you've written, you'll get marks to that. That will give you edge in scoring. It's similar for AMA also. Similar for AMA, wherever there's a calculation, do then and there. Do the calculation then and there. In case, suppose if you're doing ABC analysis, there you can't do. That time, you need to take 3 pages for ABC analysis. Do the main performa part. Come to the side page. Do the resources and calculation of that. Accordingly, post the values here. So, you should be simultaneously doing for that. Apart from the ABC analysis in, or maybe the first chapter, the throughput analysis, bottleneck, where you need lot of columns, then you can take the first page for the performa, second page for the working and keep on transferring there. That will give, like don't do in the calculator, write in the question, then come and do the working note. That will double because again you need to use the calculator. So when you use the calculator, write the amount in the working note, come back immediately to the question, fill it off. So for those questions like this which need this column preparation, you can take this part. Apart from that, any question, or you may say you want to do a small calculation like 100 units take 10, so 90 will take how much? So that kind of thing you can do in that question itself. No need to write a separate note for that. And again, coming to the PERT chapter or even networking where you have this columns and diagram preparation, do it with the pencil first. Once you're satisfied, then go and do with the pen. Like draw with a light pencil and then go and do with the pen so that you will not make any mistake and don't do strike offs. Okay, so this is the method. And in AMA, you can have the possibility to write formulas when you're doing the sum. That will show that you remember the formula, you know something what you're doing. At least that will add points. I'm saying the example standard cost, you can mention the point there. Or even PV, in the CVP analysis, you can write the formulas. So writing the formula will give you an edge. For example, in the OR also, you can mention what is the meaning of this assignment, what is transportation, short definition, then start it. And for the transportation part, when you do this comparison table, take a fresh page. Okay, don't do in the don't try to keep it restricted. Take a fresh page. Okay, always maintain long distances and always whatever you're selecting, circle it. So the examiner will know that you're selecting so and so quantity for so and so amount. So this all small tips and tricks will help you build more efficient in your paper presentation. And coming to one last thing, my friends, coming to the direct text where you have case laws, please prepare the case laws. If you want the case laws, I have a summary of the case studies. I think it is for free. Yeah, I don't remember it, but it's long there in my Instamojo page. I try to keep a link for that for you. So it is for free, I guess. You can once check it out and then download that thing. And you can use that direct text PDF, which is summary of the case laws. Almost I think 2 or 3 case laws are there. You can take that thing. And any question, if you write the at least summary of the case law, including the case name, it will be a tremendous victory for you. So you remember the case, you understand, you need to have one revision of the entire case. You remember the content of the case and remember the case name and the summary, put it in the answer in between and draw a box. If you perfectly know the question and perfectly know the case law, make a box. If you don't know, just write it there, don't highlight it. It will give you an edge. Definitely it will give you an edge in the examination, boost your marks like anything. So focus on the case laws also. You have less time, but still you have time. And one last piece of advice, my dear friends. Now 15 days or less is there for the exams. And still now we'll be confused as to what to revise, what to study. But one thing, whatever comes to your mind to study, study it. But don't revise, keep on studying those things which you know it will not be that helpful. What I mean, for example, 5 heads of income. It's important. But apart from that, the big things like assessment procedure, TDS, securitization trust or trust concepts or international taxation have somewhat more weightage compared to 5 heads. So again, revising 5 heads will not give you a better edge because 5 heads of income is for the CA intermediate. You need to focus on these things in revising. So take a conscious call when you're revising it. You can't jumble up in the last 15 days. Okay. So saying this, my friends, I hope you like this video. And if my voice is low, I'm sorry for that. I am not having a mic to record now. But still, I thought to share my advice to you all. So keep studying. And I'll see what other advice I can give you in this last moment of time. So stay home, stay safe, stay healthy, be focused, keep on studying. All the best.